Hello, comrade. I'm Philip Chavez, one half of Shy Energy, alongside my sister, Sarah Chavez, behind the camera. Out of the four topics, we decided to choose renewables. Renewables because they're becoming a lot more prominent in our society, from the US to China to everywhere. Everybody is deciding to use renewables. And in a dying world like this, we need a clean and reliable source of energy. We chose innovation as our way of experimenting because it's a good way to show exactly what we're trying to display through a model. And another reason we chose innovation was because we love to work with our hands and build things, and this is just like the all around the perfect way to do so.
As wind farms pop up around the country, more land is being used, which affects industry, the economy, agriculture, as well as some animal habitats, and this makes land a diminishing resource. As we thought about this problem of land usage on wind farms, we decided that we would do a project on making windmills different heights, and then we thought about how we would be able to make them retract. As this idea progressed, we realized we needed to not only make the windmills retract, but we also needed to make them face the wind direction and make sure that the blades would not touch as they spun around. As we furthered our research, we realized that this problem would also help the idea of windmill aesthetics, which is a problem facing many areas with wind farms, especially since they've been known to degrade property value around them, as well as some people have been complaining about how they look. Retracting the wind turbines when there's little to no wind would help the aesthetic of passerbyers, tourists, and the people living in the areas of the wind farms. Not to stray too far from our topic of land usage, we realized that it was a two-for-one problem solved. Not only would retractable windmills reduce the land usage of wind farms, but it would also help the aesthetic of wind farms in certain areas.
Unfortunately, as we went through ideas, we couldn't go through with our main idea, which was to code this 30 rod into going up and down and automate the process of the windmill going up and down instead of manually doing it. The reason that we didn't use the coded microcontroller and the threaded rod to automate this process was because this did not fit inside of the tube for the wind turbine. Instead, we resulted in using the jack, which we had to manually crank and then press of a button would make it go back down.
We did research on the spacing of large turbines, and obviously our project is on a very small scale, so we interpreted that information to make sure that the windmills would work on a smaller scale with spacing and our fake wind that we used a fan for.
In our research, we actually found there are many ways to raise a wind turbine on large scale, such as scissor lift, hydraulics, and like elevator type design, but we resulted in this because they didn't make a scissor lift in small scale, which would have been our best option. So in our project to simulate the wind, we decided to use this wind machine fan that actually produces a decent amount of wind. And obviously for a wind turbine, obviously at any scale, you need a sufficient amount of wind to produce the energy needed for, let's say, a house. On a larger scale, the wind would be a lot more turbulent and there would be a lot more environmental factors that would affect the wind turbine efficiency, which would ultimately affect the rotor inside of the turbine and not produce as much energy needed. One problem that we encountered with these small scale turbines is that they don't move towards the wind direction the way that it is blowing, which large scale turbines do. When there's a wind, let's say coming from the south, they face that direction, same as north, they would turn that direction. In the end, our model did do what we wanted to do, which was when one is placed above the other, they do not collide. Again, this is saving about half the space because you are putting wind turbines closer to together, which, yeah, it saves a lot of space, which is what we wanted. So there's more access for like farming, agriculture, habitats for animals, who knows. Just to sum it up a bit more, when the fan was placed in front of these wind turbines at different angles, it did work, and these wind turbines did effectively not hit each other and not collide. Once again, our innovation did work on a small scale, which we wanted. And yeah, we had a great time doing this. Thank you to everybody that helped us. This was a great opportunity. Thank you for everybody, our mentors, and thank you for helping us innovate.